Hey, hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel named Learning to Learn. As you can see, this is my channel and I've uploaded a lot of stuff related to commerce. And in this particular lecture, I'm going to start with a new subject. That subject would be organization behavior. अब ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बिहेवियर एक पूरा नया सब्जेक्ट है. ये अलग अलग कोर्स करिकुलम में या अलग अलग यूनिवर्सिटीज़ में इसका पूरा सब्जेक्ट आता है. एंड वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग दिस फ्रॉम ज़ीरो. एंड ऑल द सजेशंस व्हिच यू हैव गिवन मी, लाइक मेनी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स हैव गिवन मी द सजेशन, मैम यू कैन से फर्स्ट यू कुड अपलोड द एंटायर सिलेबस सो दैट बच्चे उस सिलेबस को फॉलो कर पाए, विच सिलेबस यू आर फॉलोइंग एक्सेट्रा. एंड द टाइटल्स, दैट इन द टाइटल इट शुड बी क्लियरली मैं that what are the topics I'm going to teach in that particular class. So taking all your topics or all your suggestions into consideration, let's start today with our first lecture of organization behavior. So if you are unaware, I'm basically on Unacademy. I teach there and I'm there since a very long period. So you can come here and attend various lectures. I usually have my special classes that are free of cost classes from 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. every day. So moving forward with that, you can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. And if you don't know how to follow me, just go to my channel. In this corner thing above my head, if you can see, there is Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Telegram, Unacademy. And if you are using mobile, you'll not be able to see here. Then you can go to about and scroll it down in your mobile. You can watch this, okay? You can follow me on various other platforms as well. Now, starting with today's topic. Today's topic would be organization behavior. Yes, so these are my handmade notes, handwritten notes. I'm really sorry. So these handwritten notes you can download free of cost with the Telegram application. I'll give you the links in the description box below. By chance, if you don't get the link, what you can do is you can go to my channel. There is home videos. So sorry, there is home videos, playlist, communities, as you can see here, channels and about. You just have to click to about. Scroll it down and you'll get notes group Telegram. You can see at the bottom of the screen, right? So just click there and then you can download the notes. And this session would be entirely in Hindi, and I would be recording one more session entirely explaining it in Hindi. This would be in English. The different session would be in Hindi, so that if you're comfortable in English or Hindi, you'll be able to understand the subject thoroughly. Okay, so let's start. So I'll just you can say zoom it out a bit so that you can see what exactly are we going to cover here. And I think it's okay. It's not that you cannot read. I think you will be able to read it fine. So let's start the concept of organization. Now, organizational behavior, if you go through, it is a subject which usually includes the behavior of individual, especially employees, employers, the relationship between two, conflict management, stress management, workers' participation, many other things. It is related to group study or individual study, how the individual feels or how the group feels about that individual. So this becomes a very big important part in organizations, because when you just go through all this, this helps you to manage your people better. It can be, you can say, your employer, it can be your employee, it can be labor staff, it can be some certain people just below you. All these people could be managed in a better way if you know how to manage these people, right? So we are starting with that particular thing today. So I think let's start with that, right? So first, the concept of organization. Now, what is organization? Let us try to understand a bit like that. The first is, man being a social animal forms different organization and spends most of the time in these organizations, right? So of course, man is a social animal. He needs to socialize. He cannot live in isolation, and thus he is bound to live in various kind of groups, fine? These organizations are not the new concepts, but they can be traced back in the history. Man is okay, I think the spelling is wrong here. It's gregarious, as a result, he forms different kinds of organizations, family, social, religious, and business. So it becomes important to know the concept of organization and its characteristics. So why are we studying this? Because this has become the essence of a person in the entire world. Man is a social animal, so he or she is bound to live in the groups, and those groups are to be managed effectively. So that's why we need to understand organization first in terms of business. Organization is the group of two or more people. I'm reading the inverted commas thing here. Organization is a group of two or more people who aggregate. I'll just zoom it out. This is 200%. I'll just pick to 10%. Okay, this is fine. And I can drag this here so that you can properly see. Okay, and you can download the notes so that you can print it out as you like. So, organization is the group of two or more people who aggregate together for the achievement of same common goals. And these people who are together have different behavior, nature, and attitude. So, what this definition is trying to say, that organization is a combination of various people. And these various people are coming together so that they can achieve a particular objective, correct? But at the same time, these all people who are trying to achieve a single objective are different. Their nature is different, their behavior is different, aspirations, attitude, personality, everything is entirely different from other persons. Moving forward, in spite of these behavioral differences, all the members of the organization make the efforts to work unitedly for the achievement of the common goals. Yes, though there is a difference between all these people, their nature, their attitude, their behavior, still they work together in a group also to achieve common goals of the organization. The members of the organization, I'm reading it here so you can see which line I'm reading, fine. The members of the organization are binded together with a set of rules and regulations for the organization. So what these set of rules and regulations do, these helps for the smooth functioning of the organization, and they usually don't have any problem in that organization, right? So everything, if it goes smoothly, so for that they have these kind of rules and regulations. Okay, these are some of the characteristics which can be seen in the organization. So let us go through the characteristics, fine, and then we can end this particular session, fine. So organization is collection of two or more than two individuals. Yes, a single person cannot constitute organization, or a single person cannot make an organization. An organization is usually made by two or more than two people working together. Yes, the next one is, in every organization there exists the formal and informal relationship. Yes, we have formal relationship, which is basically based on the designations of the employees, and informal, it is based on the interest, or you can say the friendship or the informal relationship between two people. Like suppose if you like to hang out with your boss, and if your boss also likes to hang out with you, and you both make a good team, you're good friends, so that is an informal relationship. But yes, though, because you're working for your boss, there is also a formal relationship. So make sure you remember, this was in your 12th standard also. In an organization, you can find both formal organizations or formal relationships, as well as informal organization and informal relationships. Without this, an organization will not exist, right? Moving forward towards the next one. I'm reading the third point. In every organization, hierarchy of post is seen. Yes, we have various kinds of organization. You might have studied that in your 12th standard. Like we have matrix organization, we have single line and staff. Then we also have functional organization, divisional organization, etc. So every organization has its own structure, has its own way, etc. Moving forward, there are distinct characteristics in each organization which makes an organization different and special from other organization. Very true. Every organization is different from other. they have their own set of rules, they have their own set of working, they have their own set of environment, culture, etc. So make sure you remember this. Organization, a single organization is completely different from a different organization, though they both are in the same industry, they both are doing the same work, they both are selling the same products. Still, the organization structure would be different, the people involved would be different, the culture and environment would be entirely different. Now, so these are the structures that make, you can say, one organization different from other. These are the sub points of fourth point. That is, these characters, these characteristics are structure of the organization. Absolutely true, because one structure of the organization can be entirely different from the other structure. Then we have rules and code of conduct. Absolutely, we have different rules in different sectors of the society, different sections of the society, different organizations also. The internal environment, yes, many of the firms have internal environment very, you can say, cool and casual. It is not very strict kind of environment. But in many of the firms, there is a strict environment where everything is has to be gone through rules. Everything has to be communicated. There should be more transparency, and there is more, you can say, checking and auditing again and again. So yes, this also makes it different. Now, the aims and goals of the organization, yes, each and every organization has their own aspirations, own aims, own goals. The external environment of the organization, yes, that also affects the entire organization, and might be the external environment might affect your organization, but it is not necessary that it will affect all other organizations at the same time. Yes, so these are all the characteristics which makes your organization a bit different from every other organization. Fine, so I hope you have understood this. If there is still any doubt, please do let me know. I'll try to help you out. And in the next class, we are going to understand analysis of the organization. So stay tuned. I'll just upload the exact schedule when I'm going to upload and in which language I'm going to upload. That will help you to plan your studies accordingly. So till then, take good care of yourself, study hard, and take care. Bye-bye.